So, social categorization is when people use cultural or social markers to group people. So, this is a group of famous actors, and we could categorize them in multiple different ways. One way we can categorize them is based on gender. We could also categorize them based on age. So there are lots of different ways to group these people. And you can imagine that how we see people is going to influence whether we feel like they're a member of our in-group or our out-group. And we feel positively towards people that are in the in-group, and generally we feel negatively towards people that are in the out-group. And so social categorization, which is this automatic tendency we have to categorize people, leads us to feeling like people are either in the in-group or the out-group, which contributes to intergroup bias. Outgroup homogeneity is when somebody feels that everybody in the outgroup is the same. So here's an Indian man, and if you know something about this Indian man, you may feel that you know something about all Indian people. And so what happens is you kind of group them all together and say there are no important distinguishing characteristics between them. They are all the same. So if I have an attitude towards one of them, that attitude can be directed towards all of them. Or if I know something about one of them, then I know something about all of them. And so when somebody experiences outgroup homogeneity, it makes it much easier for them to also have bias towards the outgroup because they feel like, well, I know everything important. And so it's easier for them to just lump everybody in the outgroup together rather than have to take each person individually on his or her own merits. Stereotype threat occurs when you know that there's a stereotype about your group, and you are worried that if you fail, you're going to confirm the stereotype, and ultimately ends up becoming a self-fulfilling prophecy. So here's an example. Here's Sue, and she knows that there's a stereotype that girls are bad at math. So now she's taking a math test, and she's stressing out because she's worried that if she doesn't do well, she's going to contribute to the stereotype. So rather than being able to relax and devote all of her attention to the test, some of her cognitive capabilities are being bound up by this stress of confirming the stereotype. And so what ends up happening is she actually ends up not doing well because she's so concerned about not fulfilling the stereotype that she can't apply all of her mental abilities to doing well on the test. And so what we see is that people who are members of groups where there are stereotypes that they won't perform well know that the person who's going to be evaluating them knows about the stereotype. They perform worse than if the person who's going to be evaluating them doesn't know the stereotype or doesn't know which group that they fall into. So when you are doing things like taking the SAT or the GRE, just don't complete the information about what your ethnicity is or what your gender is. And then you might not necessarily feel concerned about confirming stereotypes about your group because you'll know that nobody could be categorizing your performance.